Yeah, I see it, yeah.
Worldwide, man.
Right.
I mean, it's public assistance for access for food, medical assistance, and cash.
Oh, yeah, one-stop
shop. Yeah.
One-stop
cover. 15 minutes.
You get free medical care as well?
No, they turned me down for that for some reason.
For some reason. Right, now, tell me about the Obama phone. So you had an old Obama phone, an old hoopty, and then you found out that the new Obama phones have cameras in them, so then you called the Obama phone people and say, I lost mine, and they take a new one.
Yeah, well, it's not just me, it's everybody. Like, I'm staying down at the homeless shelter here in Pinellas, and, they get the Obama phones, like, that. They help you, the Obama phone people come to the place doing that. You don't even have to go to the website, they come to the homeless.
Oh, yeah, because you know as well as I do, guys, that this assurance place, you know, they get government money for everything. They want to throw as many Obama phones out in the streets as they can.
You know who owns insurance? Virgin Mobile. And they get paid. No, Virgin Mobile, and they get paid by the government for Obama phones issued.
Yeah.
Caliber.
Oh, my
God.
Because now they have the new one. It's a slide phone, and it has a camera on it.
Yeah.
So everybody's losing their old Obama phone. They report it off your store, and in another week or two, they get the cool guy one with a little 1 megapixel picture on it.
So the Iggy is the quote-unquote lose your Obama phone.
Right.
And then somebody comes on site and gives you a free upgrade. You don't even have to go to them.
Yeah, I know, because insurance, I mean, they're sending salespeople out there every day saying, hey, which one of you homeless people don't have an Obama, or, you know,
who lost theirs?
Yeah, which one of you people, quote-unquote, the little quotation up in the mark, which one of you guys lost or got your phone stolen, huh?
Yeah.
Which one of you guys got that old, looky-ass, broken jitterbug lost or stolen? It wasn't one of the brand new one of these.
Yeah.
You couldn't even get picture messages on the last piece of crap.
But now you can.
Yeah, 1 megapixel.
Yeah, God. Damn, man. You know, if they just would abolish the Obama phone, a program. Can you imagine the kind of money we could save just on that?
because not only have
the cost of the phone that we're absorbing, but then you have the air in the minutes.
And the upgrades.
All that kind of deal. So what are you living in? Where's the homeless camp down in Pinellas? Down by the jail, ain't it?
Yeah, if you get in trouble, we ship you right to the jail. If you get out of jail, you can go right to the homeless shelter.
You know, that's a good job by Sheriff Bob doing that, though.
Is that what he did?
Yeah, because you know what? It was the streets of St. Pete for business owners there were getting kind of bad with the homeless people hanging out in front of your business. And Sheriff Bob came in and said, we have this empty building up by the jail. Why don't we just put them there and give them a place to sleep?
Now, what type of luxury do you have at the homeless shelter?
Actually, it's not too bad. It's pretty much like one step up from jail. You sleep on the jail mats.
It's basically jail, but you can come and go as you want.
Yeah, and you got to be in by 8 o'clock, and you got to sign out for work if you go to work. And you have church groups coming and feed you. It may help you in certain ways, I guess.
No, but the bottom line is, so you have to be in by 8 o'clock. Like, you just can't roll in there at midnight because you're homeless and you're getting some homeless ass. Right? You gotta be in by 8. They close the doors at 8 p.m.
No, you can come in anytime you want, but if you're drunk or stoned or whatever, they make you sleep outside underneath, like, these tent things.
But if you can come in, let's say you can come in at midnight because you're out working, it's okay then, right?
Yeah, like, I'm okay because I've been out working all night, so I'm all right.
So and even if you weren't working, you're just going out and seeing some chicks or something like that. The bottom line is, as long as you're not inebriated, worked or stoned or high, they'll let you in.
If it's past 8 o'clock, they make you sleep out there in the tents. You know those things you park RVs under? It's like metal on top with no sides.
Yeah, like an awning kind of deal.
Yeah, you sleep under there for a week or so until they let you back in.
Well, they penalize you a little bit.
Yeah.
Now, do you have to get the lights out at 8 o'clock, or is it just you have to pay? Do they have games and, like, you know, Monopoly? And
Yeah, it's just like jail. There's the TV. They have to watch the basketball and the football. And, fight over the TV.
Do they got showers and things like that?
Yep, showers, just like in jail. There's like 10 of them in a row.
Now, is there people watching you, or is it just a big free-for-all?
No, security, hired security.
And so they're kind of the bosses.
Yeah.
Is there any good-looking chick down there?
No.
I mean, do people like hook up and have relations?
I mean, can you have sex, right?
You bring them down under the bridge down the street.
So that's where the dudes are laying down under the bridge, isn't it?
Yeah.
My buddy from Mike's Pizza, well, Mike, actually, Mike from Mike's Pizza said, that's great, man. All the bums are literally two blocks from my facility.
Yeah.
I'm a dumpster diving. You guys go down to Mike's and mess with Mike all the time?
I tried yesterday, but he closes early. The jerks, we went to Checkers.
What do you mean he closes early?
Yeah, he closes at like 2 or 3.
Yeah, because I don't want you guys in there screwing with him. Mike's more of a big lunch deal. Mike's meat on 49th and Overton. It's more of a lunch deal, not a dinner deal.
Does he still have that Nedley Mandingo?
Yeah, Nedley's still got your sandwich.
Nedley Mandingo.
I'm
going to
go
hard
with him here pretty soon.
How much money are you making that week?
$8.50 an hour.
Right. Now, what do you do with all your money? Do you have like a little locker there at the homeless? I mean, do you got a bank account? What?
I consider myself, I use the program to my advantage. I'm not going to take advantage of it. I'll be out of there next week or the week after.
So the bottom line is, I imagine if you're a single guy, you can save a lot of money.
You could.
I mean, if you just, wanted to work and a place to sleep and eat for, I mean, get your food for free, your shelter for free, your showers for free.
Some of those guys have 3 paychecks saved, almost $1,000.
Really?
Yeah.
And then there's no good-looking chicks at all down there, none.
There's one, but she's like, she's all messed up.
She's on crack.
There's one.
I don't know.
There's no excuse for being homeless.
Do they sneak weed and stuff in there or no?
Oh, yeah, weed. Of course.
Do the cops come through there with the dogs every once in a while and make sure you guys aren't doing stupid stuff?
No, but they have cameras everywhere, and if they see, smoking a little spice joint, they'll shut you up. They'll find it. If you have anything illegal, you go to jail. If it's just booze or like a spice joint, they make you sleep outside.
So if it's just like a six pack, no big deal. I'm just making you sleep outside for a while.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, Woody. Well, Woody, man, thank you for the ins and outs of how to suck off the system. We appreciate that, buddy.
Well, hey, I'll send you guys some pictures, man. I just send them to your website.
Yeah, just send them to our website. We'd love to have them.
Thank you. I'll send them on the homeless shelter and on my roomies.
All right, buddy. Thank you, kiddo.
All right,
well, maybe when I go down there, I got a bunch of shirts, old shirts, Remember the Ronnie Munn shirt?
Oh, there you go. That's what she's bringing out.
But, I mean, Bubba Palooza, Miraville.
Oh, yeah.
Man, it's the stuff that we, literally are going to give away.
Yeah.
We should go down to the homeless place and outfit them all with Bubba stuff.
Why not?
Yeah, why not? Ryan, Kim, Dana, and John all want to talk about food stamps and the Obama phones. We'll get to you guys momentarily, then directly right after that we'll do the top 40. Top 5, top 40 songs from Billboard.com. First of the year, by the way. Ryan, hi, quickly.
Hey, I got something to add about the food stamps. I lost my job for about a week, filled out for food stamps because I got 3 kids. They gave $656 a month in food stamps. And I had a job about a week after, and the food stamps kept going where I was making $1,000 a week, and the food stamps kept going for 6 months. If they would actually go and look into this stuff, and check on people's jobs, they could save $3,000.
Just on you?
Just on me.
Just on you?
Yeah, my ex-fiance, she wound up going, and she lost her job due to a bunch of crap at work, and same thing with her. She was out for a month. She got like $500 and got her job back. She's a registered nurse. Wound up making, another $2,500. So between both of us, it's almost $6,000 that they overpaid just in food stamps.
Just 2 people. Now multiply that by hundreds of thousands.
Millions.
Hundreds of thousands in this state, but millions globally. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, Medicaid's the same thing. You get your kid on Medicaid, once the kids qualify for Medicaid, they give you Medicaid for a year. That you can scrub it on a year, whether you have insurance through work, they don't check it. Once you're on, you're out. They pay all dental, every penny for medical.
They're not really interested in checking on you,
man.
They don't care.
All right, Ryan, thank you, man. Appreciate it. Hey, send in Party Boy Ryan, if you could, please. I'm thinking, man, from the disco, if this is the only job that he has, he's, you know, he's dirt poor.
Oh, he could easily get all kinds of government assistance.
So what I'm thinking is,
he could get the phone,
we can get all that
food stamps,
we can get him with all that, and then he can buy all the food for the BRN.
Well, let's see what we can get for him.
Yeah.
We have to do it.
I mean, imagine, it's like we're almost the only ones that aren't doing it.
I'm probably doing it for my kids. They're 18. Hey, time to get some free food.
We got to look at the party. Party boy, Ryan, how are you, my friend?
He's dancing.
Oh, you don't have to dance. Well, I guess really you should, yeah. Because
you dance.
Yeah, every time you hear that theme song, then you have to dance.
It's burned into my head from the,
Well, there's a lot of things that's been burning, including the smell of ass.
Yeah, it's rough.
Anytime, you know what, I almost think that we change his name to Mini Horseshack.
I still don't find out who this Horseshack guy is.
Well, there's a thing called Google. If you just Google him, numbnuts. Let me ask you a question. Do you have another job or no?
No. I mean, I was working for my dad for a while, but now I treated my brother too good. He took my job.
Yeah, so the bottom line is, I mean, you're not making hardly nothing. So we'd like for you to sign up for all the
food stamps?
Yeah, for everything.
Well, I had food stamps before. I had an EBT card.
You did?
Yeah, when I got unemployment.
Really? Well, now, how does that work? I mean,
like I said, you just go to My Florida and you just fill out the deal and they just send it to you.
Oh, so you're already in the system.
Yeah, I can get it again.
Why can't you?
I don't know. I mean, I just thought I couldn't get it again. It might be a possibility.
You don't have to be unemployed. I mean, you just have to not make a lot of money.
Yeah, well,
I know, I know what I pay you. It's not a lot of money.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, are you living at home?
Yeah.
Oh, see, now, man,
just lie about that.
Yeah, just lie about that.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, just list your house. It was like, you know.
There are no food stamp police, I guarantee it.
God, we are. the food stamp police.
You can get a phone automatically when you get
Obama food.
Yeah, so I want you to go on myflorida.com, and I want you to sign up for everything you can.
Okay.
Yeah. Health, because God knows you need your teeth cleaned. I know that. I mean, you know, I want you to get dental, everything. I mean,
look how far I can go with it.
Yeah, I mean, imagine it's not illegal to, you're not giving them false information with regards to your identity.
No.
You know, and
do it all above board.
Tell them exactly what you make. You know, really? Everything correctly, and then let's see what we get.
Okay.
And if you get any food, then bring it on down here. I mean, we'll go shopping.
Yeah, it's great. You can use it at, like, Sam's Club and everything.
You can use it anywhere. Yeah. We're going right to Publix.
Get some lobster tails.
Yeah,
you can get anything you want.
Yeah.
You know, there's certain items you can't get, but it's, you know, usually like...
But if it's food, I think you can.
Yeah, it's right. It's a lot of food.
Any food item, I think you can get.
Yeah.
Well, except, you know, like, it's got to be, like, you can't get the stuff, like, from the deli.
Yeah, like, prepare, right?
Yeah, it's got to be packaged.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah,
it's fine. A loaf of bread and, you know, a pound of ham, if you want a ham sandwich.
I just showed him a picture of Horseshack right now.
Yeah.
Does it look like
you? Yeah, it actually does.
Yeah. Man, I almost think of that as name for this point. I mean, you could call him Party Boy Ryan, but I like Horseshack better, don't you?
I like Horseshack better, but I don't know, Party Boy Ryan's kind of, he's kind of got the brand going.
That's right.
He's got the theme song.
Yeah, PBR. Party Boy Ryan. All right, we got you. I want you to, you know, in the midst of what you're doing, to fill out all that stuff if you could for me, like, you know, before you leave today.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
Bye now. I got Kim. Kim, hi, you're on the air.
Hi, you can go to My Florida Access, and that takes you straight to the food stamp site.
My Florida Access?
My Florida Access.
And that takes you right to the food stamp section.
Right to it, Medicaid, cash assistance. There's even a link on there. It's not for the SafeLink phone, but it's for discount home line phones.
Yeah, we don't want any of that business. Who the hell has a home line? Home lines are so not cool. They're so 80s.
Exactly, but you can get internet then if you have a home line.
Oh.
You gotta be kidding me.
Do you have internet service?
And they'll pay for your internet as well.
I got it.
Nice. All you have to do is have the phone line. I think the phone line is $9 a month. Then you can get access to internet through Bright House as long as you have the landline.
All right, Kim.
Check how much you pay for it, and that's also you can get cash assistance for non-paying parent child support.
So if you got a deadbeat dad or a deadbeat mom, you can have the Florida or whoever subsidize what you're supposed to be getting for child support.
That's right, and they do it right there for you. As soon as you fill it out and you put their information on there, there's a section on the application. It's called absent parent. And when you fill that out, the state will go after the child support, but you will be receiving it before the process even starts with the state.
So they're basically, let's say your deadbeat dad owes you $10,000. And you can prove it, so they'll give you the 10 G's, and then they'll try to go recoup it from him, but they immediately give you the relief.
They won't give you the full amount at one time, but they'll start the payment process. Yes, sir, they will.
Well,
now, I work out of Polk County. In Lakeland, if you go to the hospital and you don't have insurance, the hospital initiates the Medicaid process now.
Because they want to get paid.
Yes, exactly.
Wow.
Free government money.
Wow. All right, Kim.
If you get the Medicaid process from the hospital, too, they'll give you all the information for the food stamps and the cash assistance, too.
It's like, you know, everybody just wants to give you. I mean, you're an idiot. Everywhere you go, they just want to give it to you. It's like, here, take it.
They're dying to give you free stuff.
Right, and let me tell you, I agree about the drug testing because a client right now that receives all services, and he's on the side of the road panhandling and getting money to go buy drugs, and they don't test him. Plus, he has $294 food stamps a month.
And gets every service that you offer.
Every service.
Great checks and balances there, State of Florida.
All right, Kim, man. Kim, thanks for your insight.
You're welcome. Bye.
Wow.
I'm telling you, the iPad is next. They're going to call it the OPAD, the Obama pad.
No.
Everyone deserves access to the Internet.
Yeah, of course.
Not fair.
No, we have just handed ourselves out to oblivion.
Yeah. Yes,
I mean, it's just like everybody thinks that they are deserving to keep up with the McCoys. They kind of feel, it's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. It's sad. Really, really, really sad.
A security check at a Spanish airport revealed something strange about one woman's breast implants. But there's more. CNN says things didn't match up.
A woman lands in Barcelona on a precious flight. Her story doesn't sound right. Then, the telltale sign. Bandages and blood under her breast.
The woman said they were fresh implants, but she had arrived on what's called a hot flight because it came from an area known for drug trafficking.
This is a confiscated set removed from a woman traveling from Colombia to Spain.
Money that they cut them open and put breast implants in their bodies. You know, like they're getting a boob job, but the breast implants are filled with cocaine. And the minute they land, they go right to the and you know, as well as I do, they're not going to a bump board. They're not going to Dr. Yucca.
That happened right out.
They're going to Pedro's cousin. He hacks them right on out.
God, imagine how dangerous that is.
Yeah.
Infection.
I wonder how much that pays, though.
Over 3 pounds of cocaine that was found.
Well, those are some fun bags right there.
Reuters reports the Panamanian woman was arrested. No word on whether she was still in jail when Jay Leno poked fun.
Boy, that sounds like Charlie Sheen's dream day. That actually was pretty funny for Jay Leno standards.
According to BBC, the street value of the cocaine is around $80,000. For New Beast, I'm Logan Tittle.
I mean, I think
she can't get that much money with that.
Oh.
How much worth the coke's worth?
Well, I gotta think that 3 pounds of coke is worth more than $80,000.
Yeah.
3 pounds?
I thought 3 pounds would be...
Yeah, a lot of money.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you would think, right? Time for the top five countdown. We do the top five songs every Wednesday of a particular genre. Today, we're gonna do top four. So the top 40, top 5 countdown, we'll do it right now.
The Bubba the Love Fun Show is counting them down.